Hi, I'm Peter Reiquam, and I'm the artist that was selected to do a project for the Les Gove Park in Auburn. We went through a long process of selection and design phase, and now we're in my studio in Seattle, and we're starting on the fabrication phase. My background is as an artist. I've been working as a professional artist for almost 40 years now. I went to art school back in the late 70s and early 80s. And I've got a Bachelor of Fine Arts and then a master's degree. And I started working for a company that fabricates large-scale public art projects for other artists back when I was a student. And so I kind of learned about the public art business and how that process works and found that it suited me. And, you know, I was able to build large-scale pieces and have my work out in public places where people would see it, as opposed to doing an occasional gallery show. So the inspiration behind this piece, which is called Crow with Fries, comes from a number of different sources, really. The park itself has a huge number of resident crows, and so that was sort of an inspiring element of the park. The site where the sculpture is going to go is a fairly recent addition to the park. It was acquired by the city to make a more public entryway to the park from Auburn Way, and so the sculpture was commissioned to identify that as an important location and to identify it as part of the park and a public entryway. So the sculpture was inspired by the crows and also by the fact that that site, which the city acquired, was once upon a time the site of a drive-in restaurant. It was Big Daddy's Drive-In. And so one cool thing that the city did was they kept a remnant of that old drive-in, the awning structure that the cars would park underneath at the drive-in restaurant. And that's there as a sort of reminder of what stood on that site. And it's sort of abstract because there's no building associated with it, and so makes you wonder, what is this? But then if you're familiar at all with, you know, American pop culture and drive-ins, you would recognize it as that. So that became another point of inspiration for this sculpture, was to make some reference to the former use of that site as a drive-in. So that's where the French fry idea came in. So this is a scale model that shows the height of the relative scale of the piece. These would be normal human beings. So the sculpture itself is 12 feet tall. And this was created during the design phase, which we've just completed. And the design phase lasted several months with a variety of different discussions about how we were going to move forward. Then I went and had this thing reviewed by a structural engineer. And once that was approved, then I started on the fabrication. What I've done now is purchased some of the materials and had them cut using a water jet cutting process. What I'm working on is taking all of these component parts and assembling them into the internal framework that will support the finished surface of the final piece. So this is a stack of parts that have been water jet cut, and it's really a little bit difficult to see right now what you're looking at, but these are a series of ribs and struts that form a skeleton. And the purpose of that is to create a structural element that can withstand all of the forces of nature and earthquakes and wind and all of that sort of thing, and to support the skin that will be welded onto the surface of this. When I say skin, I'm talking about a metal, this is all aluminum, by the way. The skin will be 3/16 inch thick plate and fastened to the skeleton, and then all the seams fully welded and ground. So it will literally be a continuous surface on the outside when it's all said and done. They're kind of abstract right now. They don't look like much, but that's kind of the fun of it too, is to see this kit of parts and how it eventually becomes something real. The whole thing will be aluminum, and it'll all be powder coated to get those colors that you see on the model. So that's another step in the process that happens after all of the building is done. It gets that finish. So when the piece is done, I think it's going to really be popular. One of my requirements was to make something that was iconic and a selfie opportunity. And so because this thing is so big, I think it's really going to have an impact. And it has a sense of humor because the bird's head is sort of a little bit cocked to the side and it's got the French fries. So I think people are really going to find some humor in it. And it will, I hope, be a real icon for not just for the park, but for the city.